example.
Okay,
about
so they want have used something. So it means people want to accomplish something, and then they, for a start, they use the tool which looks easiest because they hate it and they want to get the job done. But I guess then they are sucked in, because then problems mount. When you use a word processor and you want to write a book, then you will see it after 200 pages, maybe earlier. You lose structure. And so I think that the word processors are these things which just are so intriguing to, you think you get the work done, but at the end, if it's a small thing, just a letter, it's fine. Yeah, but the bigger things I like to see that I can use then structure of the tool, which provides help for writing big things. So that's, and afterwards, yeah, then you have used it, but I mean, difficult to say. It's the learning curve is a different one, but the stumble block is somewhere else with word processors, how to say. I wanted to, it's not so much for the geeks, it's more for the people who know what's in front of them and who can see or about estimate the path for the end result which they want to achieve. And word processors are luring in a way that everything is easy. So the, yeah, so different, yeah, different approach.
Another
example. I was in a hospital and the doctor was near the bed and then she started talking. And then I looked, she didn't talk to me actually. She talked to the computer. I asked her, what's she doing? Yeah, it's easier than typing. She's just writing the health report of me. So that's modern tech.
I seem to remember a number of years ago in the United States, doctors would dictate medical notes. I assume lawyers might do the same as well. And then the stuff would be sent elsewhere, quite possibly abroad, to be transcribed and sent back again, because that makes better use of the doctor's valuable time and skills. The good mathematicians that write math papers, and I'm sure the same is physics and so forth, they're experts in mathematics. And even if they're completely capable of becoming deep and rich experts in tech, it's not a priority for them necessarily. I think Don Knuth is a bit of an exception because he wrote tech himself. But for a lot of people, tinkering around with the mechanics of a car is not something they're interested in doing. They just want to drive the car. I think we live in a world a bit of expecting immediate results, and we expect to get immediate feedback from the computer. And if a web page takes more than half a second to load, we start to wonder, well, where is it? When's it going to arrive? And whether we like it or not, there's a lot of that attitude And if we can make things quicker and easier, I think it's worth trying.